Hi, I'm Ricardo Ramirez. I'm an extension entomologist at Utah State University. Today we're at a golf course in Logan, Utah. It's July 3rd, 2012. And in this video fact sheet, what we'll be looking at are an often misdiagnosed turf problem, and that is billbugs. Now, billbugs are a complex of beetles. They're weevils or snout beetles whose larvae feed inside of the turf, and that turf damage looks a lot like drought stress, and drought stress can look a lot like billbug damage. And so today we'll be looking at doing tug tests to figure out, do we actually have these larvae, and then looking in the soil to identify them. So the hunting billbug, which is one of the more common billbugs in Utah, is characterized by having a Y with parentheses on its thorax. There's the bluegrass billbug, which is a fairly small billbug that has even dimples throughout its thorax and its body. And then you have the Rocky Mountain billbug, also known as the Denver billbug. It's black in color. It's the larger of the billbug species. And it has deer hoof-like prints on the forewings. And then one of the other billbugs called the Phoenix billbug, it's less common. It's found in the Moab area. It has a dark M on its thorax. So billbugs overwinter as adults. And so in early spring, they'll start to make their way into turf areas and mate. They'll start to lay eggs. After laying eggs in the crown of the turf, the larvae will emerge. They'll start to feed in the crown, in the stem, making their way below ground, eventually getting towards the thatch layer and into the roots. The larval life cycle actually takes quite a while, at least a month. And after that, they'll pupate in the soil and then emerge as adults. Now they only have one generation a year, and so those adults will then be the overwintering stage. Now there are a couple of species where the larvae will actually overwinter as well. So you'll see very large grubs. And early in the spring, if you're digging in the soil and you're finding some of these larger grubs, they may be the overwintering stage of the billbug. So with drought stress, a lot of times what you get is irrigation that may not be watering in a certain area. And so the area that's affected tends to be more even when it's water stressed or drought stressed. When you look at billbug damage or insect damage, it tends to be more patchy. So if you look across the landscape, you actually see smaller brown spots. Eventually throughout the season, these brown spots will start to merge together. And so it could look a lot like drought stress. With billbug damage looking a lot like drought stress, one of the things that you want to do is look for patchy areas that look like they may be drought stressed. And the idea is to do what's called a tug test. Now, drought stress turf actually won't pull up very easily. You grab it from the base and you pull it, it actually holds down to the ground fairly well. But when you get to an area that's infected by billbugs, if you take that turf and you pull it, it pulls up pretty easily in large patches. And from here you can start to see different indicators of either billbug larvae, their excrement, which looks a lot like sawdust, or even just holes that are, or a hollowed out stem, which means that these billbugs have already been feeding in that stem, and that's why you get this brown appearance. You can use a variety of different implements to look into the soil. This is a cup cutter that we can use to actually dig in the soil, but you can also use a trowel or a shovel. All you're wanting to do is get below ground. And so here, I'll plug this in. So once you get your soil sample, what you want to do is start to break it open a little carefully, because if there are larvae in here, they might just fall out. And so as you start to break apart this plug, a couple of indicators. One is, are the actual larvae, are they feeding? They can be quite small, but also some of the larger larvae will be a little bit more obvious. As you look inside of the stems, some of the things that you can see are the insect excrement, which entomologists call frass. And it looks like sawdust, and that's just the insects been feeding, and that's the insect poop. One of the best preventative methods to keep from getting billbug damage is to keep the turf healthy. And you can do this by irrigating properly and fertilizing properly. So when you have healthy turf, even if you have billbugs in the area, that turf can recover from billbug feeding. And so that's why you want to maintain it with proper irrigation and proper fertilization. There's a couple of different types of chemical treatments that are available. They're grouped into preventative treatments, which are the treatments that you would apply before the larvae become a problem. This is early, as you start to get adult activity and egg laying. And then there's the curative products as well. And so if you've dug in the soil, you've found that you have larvae, you can use these curatives to actually control the problem at that time.